Hello. Hello guys. Morning, afternoon, evening, guys. This is an afternoon time right in Abuja, Nigeria, and it has been raining, all throughout the night till this very moment. It's still raining. Yes, guys, wonderful people all around the world, my people in America, UK, Canada, Germany, Jamaica, and any other part of the world, Kenya, of course, guys. On today's episode, we are talking about Boss Marwa and Mr. George, the man from Australia who is originally from Zimbabwe. Guys, yes, wonderful people, wonderful guys. Marwa has proven, before we dive deep, guys, let me just say this thing. Marwa has proven over time and time again to be a resilient human being. He has proven time and time again to be damn resilient. He's someone that he does not care what you say about him. He does not mind what you have, you harbor towards him, the negativity, the bad things you harbor towards him. He's someone that is purely and strictly kind-hearted and is hell-bent on helping. But guys, as I've said in yesterday's video, we are calling on his wife, like he loves to call her, which is who? Rochelle. But I prefer to call her girlfriend because they are not still yet lawfully married, guys, on a lighter note. So we've called on her on yesterday's video to ensure that she would stand up for the guy, stand up for her partner, ensure that all those negative people, especially those in your Bohansi, coming against this guy, does not and will not and should not always have their way. Guys, Marwa has proven to be damn resilient. Though, it's one of the characteristics of what? Choosing ones. Yes, that's one of our characteristics. In fact, on top of our characteristic, number one is resilience. We are thick-skinned, we are resilient, and we can take any shit you throw on us, any block, bricks, we can take it and cement it and build, a castle. Yes, guys. So, guys, let's go back into our video. On today's video, humanity over religion. Guys, if you've not watched yesterday's upload of I Am Marwa, please kindly do well to go and watch, where he talked about the man that visited from what, Australia, the man from Zimbabwe. But he told us how, the structural adjustment program, which is stopped, and it happened in my own country also back then during the president, the head of state, Ibrahim Badamasi Babangida, you understand, which was implemented by IMF. So he talked about his own country, and he said up to today, Zimbabwe is still suffering from that. And he was like, he's not trying to be political, likewise Marwa, but they were what? Against the policy of William Ruto. How the youth have stood up and resisted, and they're still resisting the financial bill madness in Kenya. So the man said that was how Zimbabwe's case started. That was how the issue in Zimbabwe started, and it led him into what? Selling all their heart with his wife, and they relocated to Australia. And when they relocated in Australia, they've been in Australia, and Marwa engaged him constructively. You can hear, guys, how they went from politics to spirituality to religion and economic. Yes, but they started with the mundane issues of life, trying to get to know who the man is and who is Marwa. From there, they now jump into what? The economics, which has to do with what? The financial issue is presently going on in Kenya, the financial bill in Kenya, which was by larger extent, he now extended it to the experiences of what? Zimbabwe. And he said that has largely affected Zimbabwe and up to today. So he was happy that the youth in Kenya were against the what? The policy of William Ruto, trying to ensure that he implement policies that is anti-people and it is not welcome. You can see, guys, that is just it. And that is just something pertinent. And that is what we've been clamoring here. We've been saying leaders on African continent, they don't care about the masses. They don't care about their people. They don't care about the people that they voted them into power. They think doing all amazing wealth to themselves is what the public wants. But I don't blame them, because the citizens in Africa are too docile. The citizens in Africa are too myopic. The citizens in Africa are too brainwashed to be what? Keyed into things like what? Parochial sentiment that has to do with ethnicity, religion, and the rest. Guys, on their discussion, that led them to dive into what? Religion. And they said, and that is the basis of the title of this video. They went into spirituality first. After, they go into spirituality. Where the man Marwan was asking him, what is his YouTube channel? He said, Camera Yogi 23. And then you know, said he's fascinated all things meditation. And that's likewise me here, guys. I love meditation. I love yoga. Honestly, every single day I must indulge in form of what? Yoga. Every single day, no matter how busy I am, I must ensure I indulge in 5 to 10 minutes meditation. Because from there, you connect, as you've heard Mr. George said, you connect with your creator, you connect with your intuitive part, you connect and you see things beyond ordinary eyes of the 3D world. You'll be seeing things from the spiritual realm of what? 5-dimensional angle of reality, not from 3D dimensional angle of reality. And that is just the truth, guys. So the man said he's fascinated by what? By meditation and ultimate spirituality. That was when Mara went ahead and what? Shared with him. He said, going forward in the future, they are going to ensure that they what? They set up a meditation center in the forest at Villa Medellin over there. Guys, you can see from there, the communication or the discussion metamorphosed into what? Religion. Yes, and that was what where it caught my attention the most. It caught my attention the most. Marwa asked him, he said, what is your take on religion? The man said he believes in God. Marwa said, likewise him. He said, but he does not believe in the societal construct of alluding or aligning with the concept of what? I am a Catholic, I am a Protestant, I am a Lutheran, I am an Assemblies of God, I am this, I am that, I am... No, the man said he does not believe in that, but he believes there is God. And he believes, even though he admitted he's a Christian, he said he believes there is God, he believes in God, but he does not, you know, subscribe to the division created by man as a societal construct, those perpetuating evil. And that is why when we talked about what the 3D world, 3D dimension of this world, man created religion. But the religion of God Almighty is humanity. So that the communication got into what? Humanity. And Marwa shared with us how he went to, or how he dated Bo, his ex-Thailand girlfriend. He said he went to Thailand. So he was asking himself, because he said, all the Thailand people, most of them, like 90%, they don't know anything about Christianity or Islam. So he now said, does that mean that all people in Thailand, if they die, they will go to hell? You see, very pertinent question, guys. The earlier we understand some of these things, the better for us as humanity, and the better chances for us to take the cost of our destiny in our hands towards making it and making a better way of living. Because we know there's an ultimate reality, supreme being, which is God Almighty. But the issue of the societal construct created by man to perpetuate all this division and suppression of what? Denominations. And that was exactly what the man said. He does not subscribe to the denominational state of religion. Guys, Marwa went ahead and talked about how Muslim, they don't want to allow Muslim ladies marry Christians simply because they have been indoctrinated that it is wrong for a Muslim girl to marry a Christian or an infidel, as some Muslims may call people that do not subscribe to Islamic faith. So it is something that in Islam, it is a crime for someone that is not a Muslim, for a Muslim lady to get married to. But it is never a crime for them to marry other people's girls. And then Marwa went ahead again and he said, Christian, normally look at what? Muslims as terrorists. You can see the division now, guys. You can see the suppression created intentionally using religion. So now, that is why they said, I have been saying this, and I said, our religion should be what? Our binding humanity. The spirit of what? Ubuntu. You are because I am, and I am because you are. And that is what we want. And if you've been following me, we started this channel with priceless Ubuntu. That is the name of this channel. Because I am. Because you are, and you are because I am. And it was inspired by Boss Marwa because I saw what they were doing to Boss Marwa back then. And I decided to champion him. I decided to tell him. Guys, so we are calling on humanity to stand up to the reality. Humanity, know thyself. Humanity, know you are created by God Almighty. That and God, in his infinite mercy and wisdom, he does not make mistake. He will never create you. Then he will not assign another human being to kill you in the name of you are not worshiping him. Can you see, guys? Can you see the three-day world we live? So our body humanity should be our religion as human beings, not religion that we didn't even ask to be born into. The creator created us. And we just grew up and realized, oh, I was born in a Christian home, or I was born in a Muslim home, or I was born in a Hindu home, or I was born in a Buddhist home. And the rest is wrong, wonderful people. So it is something pertinent for us to stand up, to champion the cause of humanity. Because in one direction shall humanity exist and coexist alongside one another. And when Marwa talked about Christian looking at Muslim as terrorists, you heard the answer the man gave. Mr. George said it was a time. Terrorism was a time created by the United States of America. Sorry, our American people. We don't mean to take a swipe at you. But no matter what, we must state it the way it is. That is why if you've been following me, I don't sugarcoat here. We say things the way they are. Even if it is my country, I've told us. Nigerians, they are the number one critic of Nigeria and the Nigerian government. That's one thing with us. We don't pet things. We don't sugarcoat things. We are not like people from Ghana. We are not like people from Ghana. Honestly, that's the truth, guys. We are not like people from Ghana. People from Ghana, they tend to pet things. They tend to make things look as if everything is working because they want to garner the attention of the outside world, seeking external validation for people to come to their country. No, like us here in Nigeria, if you like, come to Nigeria, fine. If you don't like, come to Nigeria, fine. If you like, believe what you read in the media, fine. If you don't like, believe what you read in the media, fine. But the truth is, Nigeria is not competing with anybody anywhere in the world. That's just the honest truth. Nigeria is competing with who he was or she was yesterday, and that is the secret. And another secret why Nigerians are excelling everywhere in the world. People think by criticizing Nigerians or by painting Nigerians in bad light or by calling Nigerians name it would dampen the spirit and morals or it would affect Nigerians psychologically. No, 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 no. Nigerians excel when they receive criticism. They are not doing it intentionally to prove a point to you, no. But they just believe they have to conquer territories, conquer new frontiers. And that is just the spirit. When Nigerians are not being criticized, okay, if the world want Nigeria rise to be checkmated or limited, stop criticizing Nigeria, honestly. But the more you criticize Nigeria, the more you call Nigerians 419ers, scammers, all those kind of things, name and this generator republic, it makes that the secret behind their success. If you don't know, know today. Now you know. That's just the truth, guys. Wonderful people. You can see, they had this constructive what? Engagement. And it takes brilliant minds just like that to engage one another. Pause. But there was a question Marwa asked, which the man was not able to, you know, answer for me. And I was looking forward to that question. Marwa asked him, which message does he have for the world? Which message does Mr. George, the owner of Camera Yogi 23 YouTube channel, which message does he has for the world? Does he have for the world? He could not answer the They twisted the question. That was when they now go into the what? The issue of this religion. People, humanity is our pandemic religion. It is high time for humanity to realize we can coexist together. We are one. The Creator does not make mistake in creating us as human beings. So why should we segregate? Why should we, you know, be looking at each other with bad intention, bad minds, and you are aiming at each other's downfall, trying to bring somebody down, just like what is happening in Nyapohanse with all those riffraffs, with all those guys in Nyapohanse, that they do not see good in Boss Marwa, that they are always threatened by Boss Marwa, and Marwa has never been, you know, robbed. But with what those guys have did recently, especially Gintu, and the other guy, Boss, honestly, you need to ensure that those guys answer for that crime. Don't slide. Don't allow this one slide at all. Because narcissists, as I've said in yesterday's video, that is what they do. And that is what they are best at. Narcissists would gaslight you. Narcissists would jokingly say things just to provoke reaction from you. And this reaction, I don't want you to be awaiting reactions. No, I want it to be a legal reactions, a reaction that will serve them legal injunctions, calling upon them to the constituted authorities to answer for the crimes, to answer for the allegations. And it is not even allegations, to answer for everything, because the evidence is there. Yes, guys, that's just it. Wonderful people. Humanity, it is not yet over. Humanity, we can stand up for one another. Humanity, the message for us is we are one thing, we are from the same source. So why are we killing one another? Let humanity be the religion, not Islamic religion coloration, not Christendom religion coloration, not Hinduism religion coloration, not Buddhist religion coloration, or any other religion around the world. Humanity first. We were born human first by the Creator before anything. We were born humans. So nobody should come and brainwash you. Nobody should brainwash you, humanity. This is a clarion call from me. I'm calling on us all, please. Let's give peace a chance all over the world. Let us live in peace. Starting in Nyapohanse. The toxic and negative people in Nyapohanse, give peace a chance. Marwa is just like a savior sent by the universe to save your community. Instead of fighting him, join hands with him. Let all hands be on deck towards elevating this community, because there's power in what? Constructive community engagement. That is just it. That is just it. So those fighting Marwa, the dirty swine of Nyapohanse, you see, your end has come. You are no longer making views and you are no longer going viral. So your end has come. I taught you as a chosen one that I am, if I face anyone, your end must come to a halt. And that is just the truth and nothing but the truth, because we are in tune. And guys, the Gintu, he said something. He said that Marwa pursued PA, which is right, which is wrong. Yes, I've done a video how she resigned from her position recently. Was it 2 or 3 days ago? Guys, and in that video, if you watch it from the first second to the last second, you must have heard me. I said, it seems as if there's a link between our PA resignation to the issue with Gintu. That's just it, guys. That is just the issue. So I cannot fathom, I cannot understand. Why? Because I told you, I was trying to figure out the issue. I was trying to figure it out, but I have not figured it out yet. I was trying to figure it out, but I felt something was linked. Her resignation was not just ordinary, but we've thanked her. We are grateful for her service. And we can never lambast her. We can never say bad about her. So she's entitled to her opinion. Guys! That is just it. So let humanity preside over everything. Not religion, not your tribe, not your ethnicity, not your nationality. And that is why here I call myself a global citizen. My people in America, UK, Canada, Germany, Jamaica, United Arab Emirates, Kenya, Nigeria, South Africa, Ghana, Namibia, and any other part of the world. Wonderful guys. Thank you for coming back to watch our videos. And if you're a first timer, thank you for stopping by. Here we give you the very best of content. Do well to check our content tomorrow. Wonderful people, wonderful guys. See us in our next video. Priceless love sauce. Bye-bye.